Welcome, welcome. This is Pyre 73, bringing you another Mythworld Cup 1999 game. This is a top bracket match between the Fellowship of Stoneheim and the Sabre Rummers. Pretty good match between these teams so far. It's all tied up after Sabre Rummers able to secure a 6-5 victory in the last game. They had an interesting strategy where they went around the eastern part of the map after starting north. And with that same start spot, we'll have to see if they're going to implement the same strategy, as well as see what adjustments FS will make to try to secure the win here. Looks like they will be splitting up their trove similarly as the last game, where Moby Dick gets 2 and El Bastard gets 1. Meanwhile, Yellow Belly will be netting a 3 trove for this team. And let's break down the players real quick. It is a 6 versus 7 match. We'll start in the north. For the Sabre Rummers, we have Blackbeard, Scurvy Dog, also known as Wayward One, Old One Eye, who's also known as Deacon Dawn. Next up, Yellow Belly, also known as Odin. We got Whitey, also known as Karch or Kanetch. I'm not even sure. And last but not least, Pete the Cabin Boy, also known as Neurotic. I believe Neurotic was in Fellowship of Stoneheim as well, but opting to play for the Sabre Rummers in the 1999 Myth World Cup season. Down here in the south, for the Fellowship, we got Ballistic, El Bastard, Moliere. Next up is Flummox, Pooh Bear, Atkinson, and Mobitz. And the game is going to kick off, folks. Spiders getting out to their early usual lead besides these Western Spiders for Ballistic. All the other Spiders have moved out on the map. Sabre Rummers moving all theirs early. They might be getting some tags earlier than the Fellowship. It looks like the Fellowship might not even opt to send their Spiders to the west to secure that ball, even though I believe that is the tag that they're going to need. They might lose the mid tag, but actually it looks like Moby Dick gonna come in and scoop that up with his tro. Maybe just kick away those Spiders. Nope, they're gonna turn around.
Ball captured.
And Barissi is getting surrounded over here, but he will have the support of El Bastard's tro. In fact, I'm surprised Blackbeard's pushed up that much. He should probably get out of there. Because, yeah, Blackbeard knows he doesn't want to fight that. It looks like in the west, FS contested, looking to secure this ball. They have the spider advantage, they have the berserk advantage. Now they just need to position themselves to make sure that ball is secure. They might even get in some kills. But all the action is going down here in the east. Large portion of the Sabre Rummers forces over here. Just looking at percents real quick. You got Blackbeard's 25, Yellow Belly's 20, as well as Whitey's 18. That's at least maybe 70%, at least over 60% of their team's units. And we got a melee going down here. Blackbeard already ripping through those Zerks for Peg Boy. And Pegboy's tro is going to retreat. It looks like Sabre Rummers will be able to secure that ball in the east.
Ball
as Moby going to secure this ball in the mid. Sabre actually pushing one of their balls down from the high ground by mistake. They've collected it now and they're moving it to their defensive part of the map. Sabre Rummers is going to continue the push here. FS is going to have to adjust, as you see Rumox making a move to this back ball to defend it. Should be able to hold his ground against the Zerks, although there is quite a bit of them. Once Odin shows up, he'll be in quite a bit of trouble without any help from Poolbeard's Souls.
Ball captured.
And all at I going for the kills here on the Zerks. Pretty close to taking that ball. He's gonna clean up this melee. And that ball just keeps going for Sabre Rummers. He's gotta look out. He's gotta be careful with that one ball over one eye. As Sabre Rummers are already down in the lead four balls. They're only losing by one ball, but that's a 5-point difference right there, 6-point difference, so pretty large difference. But there's almost 12 minutes to go here, so plenty of time to decide things out as Odin's gonna move in, kicks apart some fetch. Wish I got me some better looks on that. And FS gonna reclaim those balls after Odin deals damage. Blackbeard continuing to engage El Pegboy. Sabre Rummers lose their ball up in the north. Unfortunately, due to the tactics of Baristic and Ol Atkai.
Ball contested. Ball contested.
Pegboy is going to trade some health for a kill there. Take one of Blackbeard's offensive dwarves off the map. And it looks like Whitey has shown up to support this offensive force. Of course, that somewhat leaves Sabre Rummers at a disadvantage on defense. They still have some Solus and artillery back there to clear it up. As I believe Mullier's dwarf is gonna kill a bird there. He's hunting. We'll have to see what Sabre does with this offensive force in order to push. This FS is looking to apply the pressure here. But I wonder how long they will stay. And he stays a little bit too long, loses both of his spiders there. So Sabre's gonna reclaim that northern ball. However, FS is now in the lead 7-4. FS able to steal back one of the mid balls. I believe it was the one that was knocked down over here in the west accidentally. And yeah, With 9 minutes to go here, we still got a lot of time for these players to breathe and figure out what they want to do. Sabre Rummers obviously want to push here. They also have a 5% advantage to help buffer that push.
Ball contested.
El Pegboy moving in the east. As a spider for Sabre goes to contest, maybe knock a ball loose, but falls short. And Odin taking some damage on his tro. Killing that Duff might not have been worth it as it drops well below half health. Only a couple punches left in him from an opposing tro before he'd be stoned. And the Sabre Rummers once again behind the defense of the Fellowship. A little bit of action here as Pooh Bear is going to pressure Odin's troll a little bit. You can see now the entirety of the FS forces on my screen, thanks to the extended zoom feature of 1.8. We got less than 6 minutes to go here, folks. And Blackbeard is calling the charge. We got some spiders moving in. Tro getting ready to move as well. And they're going right for those fetch. They're going to be able to knock them off. Pretty damn good push by Sabres. The Zerks might get eaten up here. The artillery will be able to clean up those Solas. And Odin's going to have to double back here to help out his teammate. Although they might not need help as the Solas are now digging right into those Tro. And with these two fetch supporting them, Odin's going to dig right into the FS melee here, and Sabre's souls are getting rushed by Ballistic, but Blackbeard's dwarf, along with Whitey's fetch, is going to take down those spiders. Yellow Belly losing two of his tro, one more close to being stoned here. It's going to go down, along with a fetch of Whitey. We'll have to see if this fetch can be saved by Solas here. As it looks like it will be. Yep, effectively protected. We still got 4 minutes left here. Now the Fellowship, they only have one spider and four Solas remaining. They don't have a lot to contest their balls with. Well, Sabre Rummers, they have at least 10 to 14 Solas right there, and another 7 moving up from the defense, along with 6 spiders. That's enough to sneak up and steal those balls. We'll have to see how this plays out. See, as the follow-up battle from the initial early game battles leads to a close percentage, 44%, 3% favoring Fellowship here. And Pete's going to move right in with his soul, start dealing damage to the Tro. One of the Tro is AFK, and it's going to be stunned pretty quickly. And there it goes. As Molly's going to show up with his dwarves, trying to pressure those souls away. And another Tro going to get stoned for FS. And now these two dwarves are in trouble. They're on top of the satchels. They're going to get wiped out pretty quickly by this fetch, now controlled by Odin. And FS here effectively getting cleaned up. All that melee might help if these balls weren't in uncontestable area along with these enemy soulless. They just simply can't do anything to those souls. You may want to try pushing a ball away or something. This pig was going to move in, take out that fetch. That will certainly help in the assault. And with these souls controlling the high ground, along with the support of Blackbeard's artillery and all One-Eye's spiders, it looks like Sabre Rummers are going to come away with a victory here. That fetch going down pretty hard. But unless they're able to run that ball away, it's going to be game over. And they're going to ball them 11-0 for the Sabre Rummers. That is a 16-0 victory. The game now going from a tie in game 3 to a full 16-point swing for the Sabre Rummers. That might be enough to put them over the top, as the Untamed Allies flag rally scoring has been rather close in all the games I've seen so far. Even in the case of large blowouts. But we'll have to see how FS respond in game 5 if they have what it takes to cut down that 16-point lead and put the match back in their favor. Otherwise, they're heading to the bottom bracket, but I'm going to go through the statistics real quickly here. You cannot see the graph line. However, I can tell you with my eyes that the Sabre Rummers get an early lead in kills and stays close for a while, but then they just jump out there and maintain that buffer of 5 or 10 kills right there. In terms of damage, it's pretty close up until the end. Sabre Rummers has the lead throughout the game, and once they clean up the remaining 40% of the Fellowship, it just skyrockets. There's a huge difference in the team's lines at that point, as they are mapped on the graph. So, Sabre Rummers gonna win the BC fight here, 87 kills, 255 losses. They also score a whopping 748 damage on the map, 250 more than their opponents or so. Blackbeard coming up big, 27 kills. Although he loses 29 units, you know, his team does sweep the map here. 216 damage for him. Odin, he goes 27-4, 274 damage. He's got the 3 Tro ratios. As one may call it, pretty damn well job by him. Pretty cool, you can see the model of the Zerk as he's still falling here. Poor guy, cut down by spears. But yeah, let's not let my ADHD take a hold of me here, and let's move on to Whitey, 24-5. 171 damage. He had Soul Pack and one or two fetch there. Coming up huge for the Sabre Rummers in their final two pushes. Really opening up for a full point spread victory. Pete the Cabin Boy, 6-2 with 60 damage. Ole One Eye, 3-13 with 24 damage. And Scurvy Dog, 0-2 with 2 damage. And for the Fellowship, Baristic, 1-18 with 15 damage. Movitz, killing the most units for his team. 19 kills, 89 damage, and 2 losses, which were the Tro. Next up is Poobeard, doing a lot of the damage for his team, probably with his Soulless. He nets 9 kills, 16 losses, and 122 damage. Next up, Old At Guy, 7 kills, 21 losses, 91 damage. El Peg Boy, 6-7, 75 damage. Yellow Molly, 4-6, 16 damage. And last but not least, Rumox, 2-19 with 83 damage. So the match goes from pretty close to suddenly there is a huge lead. In regards to points scored here, as Sabre Rummer is going to walk away with a 16 point max victory and a 16 point lead. We're going to go into game 5. It's Untamed Allies flag rally, rather. So be sure to stay tuned and check that out. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this cast of Game 4 between Sabre Rummers and FS in the top bracket. Feel free to stay tuned and see how the match turns out in Game 5. Once again, thank you all for watching, and GG, folks.
Game over.